I was completely unaware of anything during my pregnancy. When she was born, she was this perfect little girl. She wasn't breathing on her own, so they took her away. And they saw a seizure. They took her down to do a CAT scan. And so within 24 hours of her birth, we had the diagnosis. We started researching right away. What is hemimegalencephaly? There was such limited information, you know, and the information that we found was shocking and scary. I mean, these kids didn't survive. We couldn't find one kid that was an adult. We couldn't, I mean, it was just frightening. She was 28 days old when they took half of her brain out to control the seizures, and she was the youngest in the world at the time. And she's been seizure-free ever since, which was the goal. Unfortunately, you know, there's a lot of other complications that come with having half your brain removed. So she has hemiparesis, she doesn't have regular use of her left hand, but it gave us her life, really. I mean, they told us she would never walk, she would never talk, she wouldn't live past two or three, I think. And the surgery saved her. It gave her her life back.
Is that your drum? Drum, good girl. Can you get the drum with Lefty? Oh, good girl! Yay! Yeah!
3, 4, 5.
Jayna has a sister, Ryan. She's 2.5 years older, and she has been Jayna's champion from birth. You know, when we were all in the hospital with Jayna, crying every day, my little toe-headed 2-year-old came trotting in, and there was nothing but joy on her face. She taught us how to treat Jayna as a typical kid. It's just not different, but perfect.
1, 6, 7, 8. Ta-da!
Hey, Jayna.
What?
Do you like math?
Yes.
Are you good at it?
Yes.
Give me some nooks. A friend of mine connected us originally to UW and the mechanical engineering department. They're looking for people like Jayna that they can kind of try out this new equipment using a 3D printer. And we said, we will drive however far we need to go. We want to be a part of it. It sounds awesome.
So when we first met Jayna, we were so excited to work with her. She just has enthusiasm and passion and loves to play. It's really fantastic when you have a partner in crime like Jayna, who's willing to come in and test lots of different designs and iterations and really engage with the research project.
She had impairment of her wrist and her fingers, but she had mobility in her elbow. So what we designed was a 3D printed body-powered orthosis. The device is body-powered and cable-driven, which means that when she moves her elbow in towards herself, the device will close, and when she extends it out to reach for something, it'll open.
There we go.
So here we focused on an affordable and easy to use device in daily life. But we're really excited about the future opportunities in neural engineering. Figuring out how we can use signals from the brain or the muscles to control these devices, along with our partners in the Center for Sensorimotor Neural Engineering, will hopefully make these devices even easier to use to improve the life of Jayna and many other individuals with brain injury.
I have really enjoyed how they have interviewed Jayna to find out what she's interested in, what she likes to do. And then when we go and see them and practice using the device, they have things there that she is interested in. I mean, that's why they built the drumstick holder. Drums are one of the very first things that Jayna showed interest in on her own. And even now, when Jayna plays the drums, Jayna will not play the drums by herself. She has to have music to play too, and she prefers to have it be her sister's piano. So they can play together. Yeah, it's a beautiful thing.